In this issue of Chalk and Pixels, I just want to send out a reminder to everybody to make sure that you're double-checking your links when you put them in D2L to make sure that they are working links. Recently, we've been having a lot of problems with students not being able to click through on the Survey of Instruction link. For the most part, this is because the company that sent us the link made some changes and didn't let us know that they were making those changes. However, these are problems that we could have prevented, and now I'm going to show you how you could have prevented this. I've already put together my survey of instruction, and now I'll go into my question and insert my link. I'll click in the text box, I'll put my cursor where I want the link to go, and now I'm going to open up my email with the survey link. I'm going to copy the entire link, including the equal sign. And now at the beginning of the link, you'll see that it starts with a www. They did not include the HTTP, so when we paste this link in D2L, we want to make sure not to delete the HTTP. Now I'll insert a quick link, and I'll select URL. Now right here, I want to make sure I leave that. Now I can paste in the rest of the link, and now my link should be functional. I'll type in my link caption, and another problem that students might have is if you open it up in the same frame. We want to make sure that we open up our surveys in a new window. Sometimes when you open links up in the same frame, it causes problems. Now I'll insert this link, and I'll save it, and now I should have a functional survey that my students will not have any problems with. Another problem that I've seen with links is I'll go to the course home, and now I'll take a look at one of the news items I've posted. You can create a course link inside many different places inside D2L, whether it be the discussion board, news items, or from the content section. You'll see I can click on this link and it will take me directly to that quiz that I need to take. However, I'll go to the quiz list. Now, this quiz is named Final Exam. If I were to delete this quiz and then create a new quiz with this exact same name, that would break the link on the course home or in the content section or wherever I have that course link. Even if I name it the exact same name, it will break the link, and I need to remember where those other links were in the course because students can get confused when that link doesn't take them to anywhere. The reason this is, I'll open up that quiz. Now when I click up in the address bar, you'll see that this is HTTPS. If I scroll all the way over to the right-hand side of this link, you'll see these numbers. That's because this address is encrypted because it's a secure website. Well, those are just a few tips of things that you should be looking for if you ever find broken links inside of your courses. Thanks for watching, and have a happy holidays.